Hey everyone, it's David from the Children's Museum of the Arts. Let's get started with today's lesson of the week. As always, our lessons are done in three parts. First, we're going to look at an artwork, then we're going to make a project inspired by that artwork, and lastly, we'll share it. So let's get started. For today's lesson, I want to look at the artwork of Allison Zuckerman. Let's look at the painting, Crossing the Alps by Allison Zuckerman. Let's start with a broad look at the entire piece, and then we'll take a second look for close details. I see a painting of a figure who looks like a woman, riding a horse. Where else have you seen images of people riding horses? How does this one compare? Look closely again at this artwork, this time for small details. So what else do you notice? I notice that the figure has purple lipstick, a denim jacket, and a pretty funky hat. Upon further inspection, the brushstrokes of the horse remind me of a classical painting, or a painting from long ago. Do all the elements of this piece look like they're referencing classical painting? For instance, I'm drawn to the cartoonish-looking eyes on the horse. How would you contrast the style of the figure to these shapes? It's done in a different style, almost cartoonish. It kind of reminds me of putting stickers on a painting. They almost remind me of emojis. It kind of reminds me of my Game Boy I had growing up. My Game Boy was gray, but you couldn't really tell because of all the stickers I put on it. Have you ever customized anything? What'd you do to it? We can do a lot to an object to make it look more personal. You can even change the meaning or feeling of something by adding your personal touch and making it feel uniquely yours. Allison Zuckerman is a painter who reclaims women in art history. She merges traditional painting with her modern take on painting and collage. Zuckerman has compared herself to a DJ, only instead of sampling music to make new songs, she references art history to make new paintings. In this way, Zuckerman's art kind of feels like remixes of images we already know. Let's look again at this artwork, this time comparing it to this painting from 1805 that's also titled Crossing the Alps. Zuckerman has said about her art, "I notice that women are often the subjects of these spectacular and significant paintings, but rarely the makers. My work is simultaneously an homage and critique of Western art history. I want to take these women out of the confines of their acquiescent past and usher them into the current moment to address and even interrogate the viewer. I want these women to have an intimidating kind of power that I feel they lack in their original setting." It feels like these paintings are showing two very different interpretations of power. How do they feel different to you? Is there any image you wish you could remix? Let's use the artwork of Allison Zuckerman as inspiration to remix our own drawings. Let's get started. Today, what you'll need for our project is some cardboard, scissors, glue, pencil, and something to draw with. You'll also want your image to remix. Glue your drawings to a piece of cardboard. Make sure there's a border on all sides for a frame later on. If you need to, feel free to patch together smaller pieces of cardboard to make your back. On another piece of cardboard, draw a shape to add to your drawing. The reason I'm using cardboard is because I like how it makes my shape stick out from the surface. If you want a white background for easier coloring, you can also just use a white piece of paper. You can even glue your paper to your cardboard for the best of both worlds. Now start cutting out your shapes and add them to your drawing. Is there an emotion you want to push? Maybe a story? Remember, we're using this as an opportunity to add a little bit more meaning to our drawing. Let's take it one step further by adding a frame now. I'm going to cut out 4 strips, 2 for the height of my drawing and 2 for the width. I'm going to make mine on the wider side so that I can customize my own shape. Try and make your frame an embellishment or a decorative detail. Here's a chance for you to literally reframe your image. I'm going for this cloud border because it mirrors my dog, and I also think it gives a nice, dreamy feeling. One last touch, I'm going to use the cut and slot method to attach some shapes to my frame. I think I'm even going to add some feet so that my collage can stand up all by itself. Let's share our artwork. Take a picture of your final piece. Your artwork has taken quite the journey from our beginning diorama to our drawing collage remix. What part was your favorite? Did the story in your artwork change throughout the weeks? Thanks for joining us for this lesson of the week.